The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer.
Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced. Renata knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong. But he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it. To take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course, Renato had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion. And he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage.
Hello everyone, welcome to the Geeky Twins and our playthrough of Stories, The Path of Destinies. Now this is a very complicated game in the way of how you should be watching it. Just because this is path number 3, you don't watch it in the order of the paths like 1, 2, and 3. If you're kind of confused, you can go back to the introduction video and I've listed on how it should be watched. Technically, I completed the game, I got the true ending, and because of that, I do have a little ball that's following me, it's a little weapon that I can turn on and off if I wanted to, but I keep it on because it helps me go through these paths faster and not kind of get repetitive in a way. So, okay, we're on number 4, and we're going to go ahead and do this.
Renato finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause, and maybe Renato could use that somehow. Lupino. Apparently, the mad rabbit had sold a Pegasus that he did not exactly own. Lupino always wiggled out of trouble, given time. But he was out of time. Lupino's frantic message said that the Ravens were going to kill him for being a rebel. If the fleet reached him first, they'd string him up for that. Never mind the winged horse. Or so Lupino had told him over the far speaker anyway. Lupino had apparently managed to confuse the judge by arguing that he hadn't actually stolen a winged horse. He'd only sold it. But wait, where was the prison? The village was empty. Had everybody fled the Ravens?
Alrighty,
People were frightened these days. Just 2 weeks passed, Renato had sneaked through an empty town and listened to the Raven's call about the Emperor's new taste in ritual sacrifice.
If you haven't noticed, stories 1 through 5 are all about Lupino and they are kind of repetitive. But after you get the true ending, you really don't have to watch it in order like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's what I'm guessing. And then also, I've updated all of my swords, and I've gotten all the gems, so there's really no reason for me to go to the chests, unless I have a low health or low energy. So I'm not really looking for the chests or anything like that. I do have to still level up in skills, so I'm trying to find a lot of the fighting areas as well as the skill altars. I have to find when I can. That's what I'm kind of doing now as I'm playing through from
Ravens
now on.
Ravens were landing everywhere. The advance guard.
I'm trying to find fighting areas
and altars.
If
they got to Lupino first, they'd eat him for breakfast.
Is my main goal.
A snack. Ravens weren't picky. If they got hungry, they sometimes forgot to interrogate their prisoners. Even top spies like Lupino. Well, unless he really was a traitor, obviously. Then they'd probably pin a medal on his chest.
Oh, a glitch. Okie dokie.
Lupino would betray him. But now Renato knew that. What would Lupino do if he knew that Lupino was going to betray him? Well, he'd concoct some crazy scheme, wouldn't he? That used Lupino's betrayal against him and it would blow up in his face. Yeah. Maybe he was overthinking this. Now that would be a first. Dirty and bloody, Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing his shuffle. Renato recognized the cards. It was Lupino.
The ravens are coming. Oh, the prison thing. Right, yeah, we see this guard owed me 53 ducats, so we made a deal. They're very reasonable people, actually, for weasels. Now, I got a brilliant plan to kidnap Zenobia. We capture Zenobia, we find out what she knows, and that's the whole war right there. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Capture the Emperor's greatest general, who happened to also be a deadly sorcerer, and, oh, his only daughter? Ah, that would be worth it. And it would be nice to see her. He'd always had a soft spot for her. And, he felt sure, she had one for him. On the other hand, he could still get to the core of the Sky Ripper, even if he couldn't get the whole thing. It must have great power.
I am still doing number four, right? Oh, okay. We do.
Zenobia wasn't just the Emperor's daughter, of course. She'd been Renato's best friend in Swordfu school. And you're still mad for her, the rabbit reminded him. The rabbit had a point, and Renato had a feeling she'd want to see him again. Who knows what could happen between the two of them this time around?
She knows all his plans, chuckled the master spy.
She won't give them up easily.
She'll tell the interrogators, all right,
said Lupino. Taking her would change the game, all right. The city was already under Zenobia's control. I had to admire her efficiency. Renato shivered at the thought of Zenobia at the mercy of the interrogators. Could he really turn her over to them? But this was war. It wasn't meant to be pretty.
I can't help it. I don't need it, but it's sitting there.
was Lupino urging him to capture Zenobia? Obviously, it was a trap. But you never knew how Lupino thought. Sometimes his plans were so convoluted they did the exact opposite to what Lupino wanted. There must be some way to play on that, Bernardo thought. Gogglers. Bernardo hated gogglers. It was almost impossible to sneak past them. If one didn't spot you, another one would. So, what's this plan of yours? Use me as bait, said Lupino. And he outlined a slightly complicated plan that involved geese, a net, setting the farfare a little bit on fire, Lupino dressing as an old blind toad, and Renardo hiding inside a monstrous watermelon. What could possibly go wrong? Thought Renardo.
So I think I'm not going to do it. I'm going to reject it. But if you want to see it go through, I think that's story number 5 says yes to that. So, yeah, story number 5 will say yes to that if you want to see what happens when you say yes to that.
Oh, go ahead. I'm sure you know better.
Sword will make me run fast.
Renardo slinked through Zenobia's ship, making no sound at all. Where were her guards? Finally, he reached her bedroom. She was curled up at her bed. Oh, he'd forgotten how beautiful she was. How sleek. How soft. He tapped her on the shoulder with his sword. She became smoke. And he noticed he had a blade to his throat. Stay a while, purred a familiar voice. Did you really think you could capture me? Zenobia said as her ship lifted off. Now I just wanted some privacy, Renardo said. Renardo knew she still had feelings for him. Maybe he could just cut to the chase. But was timing right for that?
I knew he could still feelings for her. Maybe he could still... He could just go on and feelings card and win her over here and now. But he knew he still had feelings for her. Well, maybe... It was premature to play the feelings card. Maybe it was just a secret plan.
I know how you feel about me, baby. I know you want to be with me, Renardo said. What? The Emperor's evil, babe. I'm nice. Remember how nice I was back in school? You were an idiot in school. You said I was funny, said Renardo, starting not to like how the conversation was going. The Emperor pulled me out of an alley. Don't tell me he's evil. Yeah, but... Did you ever wonder why? No, I didn't. Why don't you ask him? Well, because I know why. He wants to sacrifice you. You can tell him that when he interrogates you. Can't we just start this over? But Zenobia shut him in the hold of the ship. He had no one to explain anything to until he was brought to the Emperor's interrogators. After that, it was just screaming. He had tried something bold and paid the price for it. Did you ever wonder why the Emperor adopted you? And he told her why. His Imperial Majesty wanted to bring the lost gods back. They could make him immortal. But to seal the bargain, he needed a sacrifice. Someone who truly loved him. You're lying. She was furious. You can't prove that. I can. And so, they set sail for the Nexus.
Accepted it. The book one didn't really count because the one you died in. That one chosen path. In.
The scientists at the observatory have resurrected one of his victims. Well, he's not exactly alive. But it can talk, and it can't lie. You took a big risk. You know, I could just cast a spell to make you tell me where the rebel base is. And you wouldn't consider that cheating? She frowned. Ugh, fine. Let's go get your witness. The rebellion had started after atrocities that the Empire hushed up. Renato had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred for one book. He had slept in a burnt village. Dead kittens and puppies had come to tell him what the Emperor had done to them.
Caught up with him. Don't you think I'd know if my father started practicing black magic?
Why? Would you want to join in?
Oh, no! No, I'd destroy his books and...
All right, I suppose I wouldn't. She stopped, troubled. He ran on. Had been searching for a way to save the rebellion. Lupina wanted to capture and interrogate Zenobia. But if he could show her proof of her father's madness, maybe she would join the rebellion. Energy spheres. Easy to dodge, but boy, do they sting if you didn't pay attention.
Damn it.
Yeah.
The observatory was a burning hulk. Dead scientists and black feathers everywhere. The Ravens had taken care to burn the reanimated witness to cinders. Zenobia stared around, shocked. The scientists had been neutral. They had no part in the rebellion. "Take me to your council," she said, shaken. "I have things to tell them." It was what Renardo had gambled on. The Zenobia would turn against her father once she knew his madness. But the rebel base was secret. Could he really risk taking the Emperor's daughter there, even if she did love him?
Okay. Did he really convince her, or was she playing him like a fiddle? Leading her to the secret base might be a disaster. He should lie about the location of the base until he was certain of her sincerity. He would take her to the mountains. Did he really convince her, or was she playing like a fiddle? He came this far, why hesitate now? He should take her to the secret base. Okay. You gotta trust her.
Renata reached Lupino by Farspeaker Toad, the one creature the Ravens had left alive at the observatory. Lupino seemed awfully anxious to meet him at the secret base. If he was a spy for the Empire, he'd turn around and reveal the coordinates to the Empire, jeopardizing the entire rebellion. But Renato couldn't bear to think that Lupino would commit such horrible treachery. There was still good in the Mad Rabbit. He felt sure of it.
"I'll meet up with you at the base," Lupino said through the toad.
"Good thinking." Renato gave him the coordinates. "There's a shuttle here I can borrow." Renato found Zenobia in the chart room. "I've been having awful dreams," she said. "Dead kittens and worse. I thought they were only dreams, you know. Why would anyone want the lost gods back? In those days, the favorite of a god could become immortal." She held herself and shivered. "He wants to become an eater of souls." "Well, I'm not afraid of dying. Just tired of boredom," Renato said, but she didn't laugh.
Silence fell as they flew towards the ruins of the city of Ubar, where the rebellion leadership was hiding. If Zenobia couldn't help them fight off her father, no one could. As they touched the ground, he could smell the ravens and hear their hungry caws in the distance.
"They're probably looking for me," she said. "You go on ahead." She had that fiery look in her eyes that he'd always loved. It was a bit odd, though, how easy she'd been to convince. It was what he'd gambled on, but he'd expected more of an argument. She'd always loved to argue. She considered it the fastest way to the truth. Maybe she'd long suspected the truth. Sometimes all it took was taking the bandages from your eyes. That must be it, he told himself. Zenobia, Hypatia, the kid's mother. Renato had never thought he'd date a librarian. He'd always figured himself for the barmaid type. But then, he'd never figured the library of Ubar would have comic books, or that Hypatia would know anything about them. He missed her.
That's the first time they talk about her.
Zenobia had really turned. The war could soon be over. She could send orders to the fleet that would leave their defenses wide open. The rebels could sail right in and capture the Emperor. Victory, but not too many casualties.
Damn it, I can't go back.
They caught their breath under a ruined arch. "It's beautiful," she said. This was the library of Ubar, he said. Your father's ravens thought they had an ancient book. She nodded. Was she crying? This was exactly what I wanted, Renata thought. To turn her to our cause. So, why do I feel something is terribly wrong? Because nothing ever goes this smoothly, is why.
Say goodnight, Gracie, said Renato, wondering who Gracie was.
Wow, I almost died.
Long stairs. So he was close to the rebel base. He was on fire. So far, so good. Chest full of old banana peels. There had to be more. Who was?
Council toads swarmed around Zenobia, shocked she was there, shocked she had changed sides. Then the walls exploded. He heard toads croaking, "Oh, the ravens!" Blackbirds were pouring through holes everywhere. "It's a trap!" cried the council speaker. In the confusion, he saw flashes of magic. Then Zenobia being hustled off by Imperial troops. So... she had betrayed him after all. Renato ran for his ship. The Farfarer flew into the clouds, barely losing the Imperial ravens pursuing him. The rebellion was lost. And he had lost it. There was nothing to do but find Zenobia and make her pay for her treachery. Oh, his heart ached.
I was not expecting that, actually.
He still loved her. But he had trusted her and he had been a fool. She would be back at the fleet. Gloating with her mad, bloodthirsty father. For all Renato knew, she was helping him bring back the old, lost gods back from their exile. Renato landed in the middle of the Imperial fleet. The rebels were losing badly. Without leadership, it was a slaughter. Renato felt strangely free. Trying. To think about how he had lost the war, trying not to think about how he had loved Zenobia, blinded himself to her treachery. That's what it meant to be a hero, to keep on fighting after the most bitter of betrayals, to never know if you could trust anyone. Cats, what a waste of fur. The portal was heavily guarded.
must go someplace they really didn't want him to go.
Okay, that kind of glitched.
What kind of raven can't fly? Thought Renato. What had happened to Lupino? Had the mad rabbit fled to safety? Or was he forlornly carrying on with the few rebels Renato could see here or there? It didn't matter anymore. All there was slash and spin, parry and lunge, over and over as he fought his way across the fleet. All there was finding the girl he'd once loved, who had used his love against him and putting as big a hole in her heart as she'd left in his. And suddenly, Zenobia was there, advancing on Lupino. So the mad rabbit had survived.
Save me, or I'm done for! Screamed Lupino.
Zenobia turned, showing her teeth in a smile.
You're alive!
Renato ran towards the witch.
Lupino's the one who betrayed you! She shouted. He warned my father!
Before he could think, Renato sank his sword into the sorceress. She stared at him, heartbroken.
No! Lupino's the traitor!
Renato had an awful, sinking feeling in his stomach. Then, he felt a knife in his back.
I'm afraid she's right, said the mad rabbit. Ain't I a stinker?
Then, the sun went out. Damn it!
Story completed. Story number 4, An Endless Moment. I am the hero who keeps on fighting even after the most bitter of betrayals. I got 20 ore. I rescued Lupino, find Zenobia, rejected Lupino's plan, and I trusted Zenobia. Zenobia was the Mad Emperor's daughter and his greatest general. Convincing her to join the rebellion would split the Imperial forces and turn the tides of the Civil War.
He could show her proof of her father's madness, and he did as they witnessed the slaughter of innocent civilians by the Empire. Zenobia was shocked. He agreed to meet the rebel leaders, but when they arrived at the secret base, the Empire attacked. For Renardo, it could only mean one thing. Zenobia has tricked him into revealing the location of the base, and it broke his heart. He chased her and swiftly killed her as he welcomed him with a smile, and then he died, stabbed by Lupino. Too late did he realize who the traitor really was. And that ends story number 4. Later, and as I said, thank you guys for watching.